So today's class is about pointers in C language. So how shall we understand this pointers in C language? Most of the people have a difficult overview of pointers in C language. Okay, I try my best to explain you what are these pointers. First of all, they are not monsters. They are not X-Men's, or they are not Spider-Man's, or they are not any anything like a devil or evil. It's a very simple concept, but yes, when we are using them, it will be more complicated. But definitely, if something is really complicated, that means it is more useful. Definitely, right? Rocket science is too complicated, but it is more useful. The same way, pointer is not that complicated, but it is actually useful. Let us try to understand what is this pointer. So here I am making a void main program. Okay, main program, and here I'll create int a is equal to 34. Let me apply CLR SCR to clear the previous screens, and I'll use getch to keep my output for a while, to make my output waiting at the moment. So first let us understand what is the value and what is the address. So every value, I mean to say every variable has a value and an address. Every variable has two properties. One is value and an address. Here in this case, the name of the variable is A. The A variable is having two properties. One is value and another one is address. So if you want to print the value, you have to use printf percentile d comma a, and I'll use slash n here, and I'll say this is the value of a. So it prints the value of A. This is the value of A, 34, and it is waiting for the output. Okay, and enter. Now I would like to print the address also. How can I print the address of A? Printf percentile D comma ampersand A. So ampersand A gives you the address of A. Is it okay? So it is like, okay, now let us see the address. Does it have an address or not? Okay, the address is there as -12. What? -12 is the address. Actually, addresses are two big numbers. While you are printing those big numbers, it is beyond the integer, signed integer. So let us print the address in this fashion. Addresses will be beyond 32,767. Such big numbers, while you are showing in percentile D, it will show the signed representation of that big number. If you see the output, see this 65,524. What is that? That is the address of A. What is the value of A? 34. So by using this address, I can actually access the value using that address. For example, if I want to access the value of A, I use percentile D comma A. Is it possible to access the value of A with that address, through that address? Okay, don't worry. You see here, I have another variable called C. The C can store the value, the address of A. If I say printf percentile U comma C, it it will give you 65,524 again, because it is the address of it. But through that address, that means through C, because C is having that address, through that address, is it possible to access the value of A? Because I have an address, so can I access a particular person in a particular place? Yes, of course. Suppose if someone knows my name, I'll tell you the incident. Try to feel it is a fake, but try to understand. I used to follow a girl. She used to live somewhere in Banjara Hill. I mean, one particular place. I don't know her name, but I know her address. I know her address. Okay. Finally, one day I found that she studies in one engineering college. And I went, I have gone to that engineering college, and I found her. She is going into the electronics group. And I know, somehow I identified that is a second year. So I can know her name, right? How? I just entered into the class and I asked one of the girl that so and so house number. Okay. What is the name of that girl who lives in that house number? So I am trying to access her through address. So this is how I am doing it now. The same way through address, is it possible to access the value of A? Let me try. So if I print C, it will print only the address. If I say star C, it gives me an error. It is saying invalid indirection. If I want to access a value with their address, I have to store that address in a pointer, not a normal variable. If I have a pointer here, pointer C, then you can see this. The answer is 34. I'm accessing the value inside A using its address. I stored its address in one pointer and I'm able to access the value of a variable using its address. Yes. Okay. Finally, I met that girl. I came to know that girl name is Niharika. I don't know how it is happened, but it happened. So like that, you can actually access a particular value through its address, not directly with the variable name. What is the need? If I want to access the name, the value, I can directly access through the variable name itself, right? But every variable has a limitation. I can access the variable only inside the block. I can access the value of A only inside the main. I cannot access the value of A outside the main using A, because A is not accessible outside these two brackets. But if I have an address, I can access it in any function, in any place, anywhere. But if I have an address only, then you will understand it later. But right now, you just think about how to access a value through its address. You have to store that address in a pointer, and using that pointer, I can access that address. Okay. Now let us come to the example. Suppose if I say percentile U, I'll use directly percentile u, which will print unsigned representation of a number. Okay, it is nowhere related to pointer. If you want to see the pointer, you have to use percentile u. There is no relation. It is going to show the, if percentile d is going to show the signed integer representation. What is a signed integer representation of 65,524? That is -12. I don't want that. We have already discussed this very detailedly at the time of format string specifiers and printf. Okay, you must have forgot it, but anyways, percentile u gives you the representation of unsigned integer representation of a number. Okay, so let us see this example. If I say printf percentile u comma directly a, what is the output I am going to get? I'll let me delete all these things. Printf percentile u comma a gives me the unsigned integer representation of a. What is unsigned integer representation? That is again 34. Whether it is signed integer or unsigned integer, obviously it is 34, because that is the only value. Next, if I say printf percentile d, sorry, slash n percentile u comma ampersand a, what is the output I am going to get? Address of a. What is the address of a? 65,500. Shall I have a better better view? So a value is 34, address of a is 65,534. Next, if I say c, what is the value I am going to get? Output 65,535. So that is nothing but address of a. Okay, yes. Next, what happens if I say ampersand of c? It gives you, even c is a variable, c is also a variable, right? C itself have one value, as well as it will also have one address, no? Every variable has a value as well as address. So if I say ampersand of c, it will give the address of c. That is 65,522. So this is address of c. Now printf percentile slash n percentile u comma star of c, star c. So at the time of initialization, if I say star c, means c is a pointer. At after initialization, wherever you use star and a variable, the meaning, internal meaning of this is equal to star c is equal to value at the value in C. Okay. So this, what do you mean by this star of C? Value at value of C. What is the value of C? What is the value of C? That is, what is that? 65,524. So what is the value at 65,524? What is the value at 65,524? That is 34. So that is the value I am going to get it. Okay. So this is not the declaration. I am not telling that C is a pointer. Only at the declaration, if I say star C, that means I am defining C is a pointer. At any other place, star C means value at the value in C. Okay. Okay. Next. Now let me see how many of you. So what is the output I am going to get here? What is this? This is nothing but A. Yes or no?
Yes.
Next. Slash n percentile u comma star of ampersand A. So value at ampersand of A. What is ampersand of A? So 65,535. Right. So let me change this value at. So whenever it is, the meaning of star means it is value at. Okay. Value at. What is ampersand of A? What is the value of 65,535? What is the value at 65,535? Yeah. So this is nothing but A. And then let us see. What is output? What is the value of ampersand C? 65,522. That is the address of C. So what is the value at 65,522? No. So be patient only at this moment. Once you are clear with this, you never get any issues in pointers. So this is A. And I have 34. And the address of A is 65,534. The same way I have one pointer and this name of the pointer is C and it is having what? 65,534 and it is having the value, it is having the address of 65,532. Right. Now what I am asking you, if I say star of ampersand of C, what is the meaning of it? That is nothing but that is equal to star of what is the address of C? 65,532. What is the value at 65,532? That's secured. 65,534. So let me see the output. I mean, sorry, here it is not 34, it is 24. 24 and 22. Am I clear? Yes. Okay, good, good, good. So now, how can I access the value of A with the address of C? I know the address of C. I don't know the address of A. I know the address of C. I don't know what is there in the C also. I have only the address of C. Through address of C also I can access it. How? You just enjoy. Even if you don't understand, don't worry. Big engineers don't understand this. You take time, but keep on observing the same thing. Keep on listening to the same video again and again. You'll understand it. So now I'll get the output as 34. So through the address of C, not the address inside the C, through the address of C, I am able to find out. Okay. Suppose I don't know the Niharika's college also, but I know there is one maid who is working in her house. And I know her address, not the Niharika's address. I know the maid address. Through maid address, first I'll go to the maid address and I'll ask maid, get the Niharika's address, and through Niharika's address, I'll get the Niharika's actual. So this is little too much, but finally what I want the value. Once I get the phone number, it is mine. Anyways, I'm sorry. Don't be offended, girls. I'm just giving you a simple example. All the Niharikas, please excuse me. Okay. That is one of the best name I have ever heard. Okay. Anyways, so this is how things work. These seven lines actually changed my life because I understood this concept very first in the entire class. Otherwise, I am nothing today. So you will understand it very soon. Don't worry. That's it for today. This is about introduction to pointers. Hopefully, we'll do much better videos in the future. Thank you. Please subscribe and like my video.